Hello and welcome. My name is Robin and you're watching A Robin Reads, where I read a lot of different books that you probably have never heard of. So this is going to be the second part of my wrap-up vlog that I'm doing in July. Let's just start with it. So I actually DNF'd 3 books this week. Let's talk about those first. I thought it would be fun just to mention those, because I don't really do that, but let's do that now. First up was Rebecca by Daphne du Maurier. This one I actually DNF'd around here, so I had this part left, but I just couldn't finish it. I thought this one would be spooky, mysterious, but it totally wasn't, so therefore I DNF'd this one. Next up, I DNF'd The Lost Ones by Sheena Kamal. I'm not going to do pictures because I DNF'd this one because the main character was pretty annoying and it felt like a very basic thriller with a female main character, and I don't really like those. The mystery part of it didn't feel interesting, so I DNF'd that pretty pretty early on, 13% in the book. And then the other book that I DNF was The Devil and the Dark Water by Stuart Turton. DNF this one at 16%. I want to read this for a challenge, but yeah, these kind of books just aren't for me. So then the books that I did read, so the first book that I finished was Convenience Store Woman by Sayaka Murata. So this one I listened to on audiobook, which I highly recommend. I really like the audiobook, and from the beginning I really loved this book. I just really enjoyed the main character and just her perspective on life. I really enjoyed that. But then after a while there came a character into the story that I really, really disliked. And not in a good way. You know, you have characters that are a little bit on the gray side that you're like, yeah, okay, but this one was just bad. And just really, really annoying. Just overall, and really disliked that. But therefore I gave this one 4 stars. So this book is about this woman who works at a convenience store, and she has worked there for 18 years. She's 36 now, and basically everyone tells her that she needs to get a better job or get a husband or stuff like that. And she's just dealing with those prejudices. Basically, I recommend it, and I really enjoyed it. Next up, I read this one. This is a Dutch book. It's basically called like Brothers by Ted van Lieshout. This was a buddy read that I did, and this was also a reread for me. I read this when I was younger. So this book is about these two brothers. And one of the brothers unfortunately dies. His name is Marius. And his brother Luc finds the diary of Marius, and he decides to write in the diary to basically save the diary from his mother. He doesn't want to read the diary, but then he decides to read it, and then he finds out a secret that his brother had, and Luc himself actually had that same secret. I really love this book. It was very sad, actually. I couldn't remember that, but it was pretty sad, but also flavored with humor, which I enjoy. I don't like when a book is all sad. I just like the mix. So I really enjoyed this. I gave it 4 stars because there were some small things that just didn't feel 100%, but really enjoyed this and highly recommend it if you're Dutch, because I don't think this one has been translated. And those are all the books that I have read this week, basically. It is Saturday, so the weekend, so I will probably finish a couple of books this weekend and this week, but I will keep you updated on what I read. Hello again, so update on what I have been reading. This is going to be the last part of the vlog for this month, basically, because it's the last day of the month. And let's talk about the books I have been reading and have finished. So the first book that I finished was The Stand by Stephen King. I listened to this one on audio, which was long, and I did it for a buddy read with a group of Dutch bookish friends. And yeah, I really enjoyed the book, actually. If you don't know, The Stand is about basically this super flu that is over the world, taking over the world, basically. And 98%, I think, or 99% of all world population gets down with the super flu, basically, and dies of it. And then a select few people do stay alive, and you follow them first when the flu starts, and then when there are not a lot of people left, and then sort of the struggle with people who are trying to be good and people who are bad. So that's basically what the story is about. I listened to the long version of it, because you have also like a cut version, I think, an edited version. I think the long version was good. I didn't really think it was too long, to be honest. Maybe a little bit here and there, but not too much. I just really loved the writing style of Stephen King, and that really was in this book again. And the story was just really good. I loved all of the characters, and just the setup of everything and stuff like that. So yeah, I really enjoyed it and I gave it 4 stars. The next book I finished was The Hollow Places by T. Kingfisher. This one I listened to on audio, basically this book is about this woman who, she gets a divorce, she's very sad, and she goes to live with her uncle, who has this museum with like weird artifacts, basically. And one day she finds this hole in the wall, and she thinks like a tourist has made that hole, but when she goes through the hole, when she looks through the hole, she sees a corridor. So she's very like, how can there be a corridor? And with the neighbor, she goes in there, and they find this place with willows. And it's a horror book, adult horror, and it's pretty creepy, I think. It's not too much, but it was pretty creepy in my opinion. And I really liked in this book the setup of the story, but the characters were awesome. I just really loved those. And the humor in the book was also very, very nice and good. And also just the creepy parts, I think, were well done. The only thing that was sort of, sometimes it was a little bit slow, and sometimes some parts weren't that creepy, I think. And one thing, the sort of the mystery around this place, I saw that coming like right away. So that was a little bit annoying, but overall just a very good book. I loved the audiobook, also the narrator, so I highly recommend that if you can get that. And again, I gave this 4 stars as well. It has been a very 4-star run lately, which is actually pretty nice. And then I am currently reading 2 books. These two. But as I said, it's the last day of the month and I might finish them. But I'm just going to talk about them in advance, basically. This one I'm probably going to finish, and that is The Great Hunt by Robert Jordan. This is the second book in the Wheel of Time series. I am finally going to finish it. I am, as you can see, like almost done. I have like 60 pages left, so I will finish this probably today. I have been reading this since the end of April, so it has been a while. I'm not going to talk about what this is about because I've been talking about the series a lot. But my thoughts on it, I think it's still a good book. It's just sometimes a little bit slow and I don't really super connect with the characters yet. But I am just enjoying it and I'm very much looking forward to the rest of the series because I've heard that it steps up the game sort of more. And yeah, I just thought this book was good. Again, probably going to give it 4 stars because yeah, it was just basically the same feelings that I had with the first book. So yeah, that's that one. And then the other one that I'm currently reading still is this one, Sunday Life by Judith Visser. This is a Dutch book, as you can see. This is the second part of her autobiography series. It's her story about love in times of autism. Yeah, autism. And I'm this far into it, so not super far. So I don't think I'm going to finish it today, but we shall see how it goes. And again, just liking this so far. It's not as good as the first book and a lot of things are repeated actually. And it's also a little bit triggering to me, to be honest, because as you know, I have autism and this stuff that she's talking about triggers my autism, which is weird, but maybe sounds weird, but just things I have been dealing with, it comes through in this book and then I feel that more or something. So yeah, we shall see how it goes. And probably again 4-star read, might be less, but yeah, we shall see, but probably around that. But yeah, that is the last book that I'm going to finish this month or tomorrow, we shall see. But yeah, those are all the books that I have been reading. Let me know down below what you have been reading this month. Was it a good reading month? I think mine was pretty good. I didn't really read a lot from my TBR game, to be honest, but you know, that happens sometimes. But I did read quite a lot of books. But yeah, again, let me know what you have been reading, and I really hope you liked this video, so please give it a thumbs up, comment and subscribe, and I'll see you later.